Hello, everybody. It's time for another episode of Keith and Perry, Out of the Wilderness.
Yep, this is Keith, and I'm still Perry. Welcome. It's nice to be with you today.
How are y'all doing out there?
Yeah.
We're doing okay. We're just being in the world and not of the world, and not letting the anxiety of all the fires and the fear overrule us. As the Apostle Paul wrote in several occasions, that we must exercise a modicum of self-control. And that's control over our emotions,
yep,
and over our feelings, mm-hmm, over how we react to things. Do I feel fear? No, I don't. Do I feel anxiety? Sure. Everybody does.
Yes. I have the anxiety.
Yeah.
And it's a little hard to deal with.
It is. Yeah. It's really hard. The reason I feel no fear is because when I gave my heart to Christ and through my faith, fear doesn't live here anymore. And I refuse to let it in, because fear is the tool of an enemy. He is the tool of the enemy, enemy of life.
Yeah.
Because nothing good comes of fear.
Yeah.
Nothing.
And, yeah. And I struggle with some of this. I haven't heard whether they're back home yet or not, but I have some family that have been in the evacuation 3 order and had to leave their home and a couple properties behind for a while. I think they're okay. I haven't heard that they've lost anything yet. But, you know, we look at all this smoke and all this stuff going on. How do we... You hear us tell you, we're not afraid. And sometimes I think, me personally, the word fear can mean more than just one thing.
Yeah, so, anxiety is a form of fear. Yeah.
So, but the anxiety, how do we deal with when you're the person or persons who have gotten in your car, driven down the road under evacuation, and say, gee, this doesn't bother me. It's just stuff and going about. And then there's a whole bunch of it, and our hearts go out to all of you.
Absolutely.
All of these circumstances, your whole town's gone. There's nothing to go home to. And then some old geezer like me says, let the anger go. Let the frustrations go.
Easier said than done.
Man, that is... I've been struggling with that, not just for this, but in all the years I've lived between Oregon and Washington, the bulk of my life, I've only seen this kind of physical chaos like this maybe one other time, two other times in the last 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
We had a couple really bad snowstorms. A couple years ago, we had some really bad fire
right.
thing. So first thing we want to do, and then we'll kind of move on a little bit, is just know that no matter how hard it is, our God is with you.
That's right. You're walking through the valley. Really,
yes.
But he's with you.
Yep.
His rod, his staff comforts us.
Yep.
He leads us
by
still waters and lays us in green grass.
Yeah, green pastures.
And to be honest, I couldn't tell you how I deal with something like this. I've never been through this before.
Yeah.
I will say that this year, the year 2020, has been a year of many, many, many firsts.
Oh, yes.
In our lives. The first pandemic that's ever affected us. The first time we've had sustained civil unrest. The first time that we've ever had fires. As you can see around us, we're in Anacortes. And on the water, you can't see across the channel.
Yeah.
Is it bad here? Sure, absolutely. You can smell it in the air. You can feel it when you breathe. I just deal with what's in my realm of influence, mm-hmm, my sphere of influence. It's all I can deal with right now.
Well, and it's supposed to be that way. We can pray for everybody,
mm-hmm,
family, friends, those that we don't even know. That's very important, but again, we have to take care of me, because if I don't take care of me, I can't help take care of Keith,
right,
or his family,
right,
or if they don't take care of them, they can't help take care of me. That's where I would encourage everybody to find a way to practice the love, hope, and charity. If you see somebody, and whether you know them or not, and they're in any kind of danger with this stuff going on, stop and see if there's something you can do for them. Maybe That's it's right. A ride out of town.
Do the good
maybe
thing.
It's a couple. Maybe it's take them to dinner somewhere because they're away from home and they're not dealing with all of this very well, and they're falling apart, saying, "Oh God, why me? What do we do?" You know, that type of thing. That's where our love works. And the thing
is when God works through us, through our love.
Because when we do that, we become blessed, and all of a sudden we kind of quit being all hyper and what have you, because our focus has changed.
Right.
And so I encourage all of you and us to do that. You know.
Well, and the sermon that we had at church today really touched me, because the pastor spoke about just this situation with everything going on around us. And he said that this is God putting us through a test. Well, yes, actually he is. He's not testing the world around us. He's testing when we see all that around us, what comes in us is how he's testing us. Does it fear? Is it anger? Is it frustration? Or is it love? Is it compassion? Is it empathy? Yes, it's a test.
And it's how it helps us grow.
Absolutely, it does. Yeah. So this is where our teachings are what we've learned, the scriptures and God's spirit working within us. That's where the test comes in. And this is how we either pass or fail. You know, is it natural to get scared? It absolutely it is. I'm not going to disparage anybody for having fear in them.
No,
especially if fearing for your life or your animals, your property,
our stuff, you know. Our stuff.
But just know that, you know, God is the Alpha and the Omega. He's the beginning and the end. Yeah. He's already been to the end. He lives outside of time.
Yeah.
So he's been to the end. Yeah. And through the Bible, we can see the end.
It's been laid out. It's a good history book.
Yeah.
Tells us about before and in the middle
and then the end of times.
And then the end. And another thing I might throw out there too, because the two go together, being in the world but not of the world. I think we need to be in the world to a degree that we can use it. God allows us to use it to our advantage.
Well, we're the body of Christ. Yeah. We should be helping one another.
Right. But we should also start, and I'm not talking about being a wild, crazy prepper where you're storing, you know, 500 guns and a barn full of ammo, all of that. Not that crazy. But look around us. We need to store up some grub.
You should have at least 2 weeks of food on you.
Minimum, We need to store up things like diapers and baby foods and those things.
Medicine.
Younger folk, medicines. If you don't get medicine, a lot of us would die.
Right.
You know, so take heed and prepare both directions. While we're preparing to walk through this valley, think about our spiritual preparedness.
Yes.
This is a good time to take a look at a Bible. If you don't have one, get one. They're easy. Scripture, and see maybe all of us who believe this aren't as crazy as we sound sometimes. And that you'll find something in there comforting. And because, again, not going to beat you up. Nobody. Not going
to be. And just to elaborate too, and when I said we've seen the end, it's glorious.
Oh,
it's beautiful.
Absolutely.
It's a good thing. It's not the world ending. No, it's a new world coming.
You're right. But, and again, it doesn't matter if that takes 1 year or 5,000 years from now. The preparation in between for both is our goal in life, in my opinion, that's what God wants us to do.
Well, it's people. The goal of everything is people.
People, yeah. Because he helps prepare us spiritually. He helps prepare us physically.
Right.
Who helps me pay the rent? The good Lord, because he gave me the money to begin with. It's his.
Right.
You know.
Everything.
Everything. So, yeah. So,
absolutely.
Yeah. So anyway, that's kind of my little spiel, a good term, kind of my spiel for the day.
Right.
It's hard for me. I look out here and my heart just it cries for all of those who have that feeling that, oh God, why me?
Of hopelessness.
Hopelessness. Oh, why me? We've both, Keith and I have both been there.
Oh yeah.
Big time. Hopelessness. Yeah. It's just another day. It's just not worth it. If it's going to be like this, try to go to bed and forget it.
Yeah, but every morning you wake up and you open your eyes, you take that breath after you've opened your eyes, it's a gift.
It's
a gift from God, because we really don't know we're alive when we're sleeping. We don't.
So I'm not alive when I'm sleeping.
When you dream, it's only a couple seconds long. You've got the rest of the night where you're asleep and you don't even know you're alive.
So that's a long couple seconds.
Right? Live each day as a gift, and it will change your outlook.
Certainly will. It's and the older you get to, you'll start to realize that it's too long to go into at this point. But Keith and I were talking about this a little earlier. You know, goodness gracious, how I looked at things 50 years ago. Man, if I could have just picked up on some things then that I've picked up on the last 10, well, my life may have been a whole lot different. But then again, it may not have been either.
That's true.
But anyway, my friends, I'm gonna turn it back over to Mr. Keith.
All right. So
maybe get out of here.
I think we should end with a prayer.
Absolutely.
So, and Father, we come into your presence. And
humbly
we lift those
come into your presence, Lord, yes.
We lift those up to you right now that are stricken with anxiety and fear, and that are in evacuation level 2 and 3 areas, Lord, that we lift them up to you so that you, because you are the source of all strength, you are the source of all courage, of all peace, Lord. We lift them up for you so that you may fill their hearts with your peace, the one that's beyond all understanding, Lord, that you can give them courage beyond courage and strength when it's needed most, Lord. And we lift them up and we pray this in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
We'll see you in church
as soon as we can.